water.
Everybody in there, so they can see you all. Come on. You know, Hewitt's even in here. Come on, Hewitt. You all right? That's wet. Says it's wet. So welcome. Thank you for lingering and watching the baptism. I think baptism is a little more difficult for some people to understand in our time because we're not a highly ritualistic people. We are afraid to make public commitments to things. I mean, that happens in everything. We're afraid to make public commitments to churches. We're afraid to make public commitments sometimes in relationships. We're afraid to make a public commitment to Jesus. In the New Testament, 2,000 years ago, people had an understanding that they should do something in behavior to express their commitment. They very much part of celebrating manifestations of your commitments or manifestations of your faith. And the two things that Jesus asked us to do that have very real manifestations are to take the Lord's Supper together, celebrate. For them, it was a Passover meal, but to do this in remembrance of him. And he also, Jesus himself, got baptized. He says, in this way, it's fitting for us to fulfill all righteousness. The waters of baptism have several meanings. One of the meanings, clearly, is that when you wash your body with water, you cleanse it from dirt. And it symbolizes the cleansing of our lives from sin. And so we understand that we go under the water, we come up, that Jesus actually does the cleansing, not the water. Jesus is the one who does the cleansing. And very much part of that, too, then, is the promise of receiving the Holy Spirit. When we express our desire to draw close to Jesus in baptism, we get baptized into him. We become the body of Christ. We become connected to him as the head. And as a result, the baptism represents our devotion to him, a display of the fact that we want to follow him, and we're committed to him, and that we love him. And then baptism also represents the point for Jesus when the Spirit came on him. And we understand that when we reach out and identify ourselves with Jesus, he gives us the Holy Spirit. And that sometimes doesn't happen at water baptism, although sometimes it does. Some people receive the Spirit before they get baptized. So then they say, well, why should I be baptized? And we would say, because Jesus asks us to. It's a very simple request of Jesus to be baptized into him. And so in the first century, when people decided to embrace Jesus as their Lord and their Savior, the first act of obedience was always baptism. And you may not have been introduced to it that way, but it's very real. So I celebrate this fact that the people who are gathered here this morning or this afternoon now, that they're gathered here, they're making a statement that they're following Jesus. And really simply, they're following Jesus. And all the benefits of following Jesus is that he does for us what we can't do for ourselves. He does for us what we can't do for ourselves. We can't cleanse ourselves from our own sins. He cleanses us. We can't understand things about God without Jesus. Jesus teaches us. We can't understand God's word really well or the will of God without the help of the Spirit. He gives us the Spirit to lead us so we understand. And we become children of God under his care. And so it's a wonderful day. Baptism is a wonderful display of so many things that God is willing to do for us. I celebrate the immersion idea. We're just kind of like all into the water. We're all into Jesus, right? He's doing everything for us. So it's worth celebrating. So some of you may not have been baptized. It doesn't matter how long you've known the Lord. I invite you to get baptized. It doesn't matter if you go to our church. It doesn't matter where you go to church. It just matters that you follow him in baptism. So you're welcome to these waters. And my commandment from Jesus is just to baptize anybody who asks to be baptized. And you don't even have to have me baptize you. I've had a father baptize his daughter here. And it's a wonderful display of the grace of God because baptism represents you with Jesus Christ. I'm peripheral. So with that, I've got I've got four people are willing to be baptized, and I'm and who's first? Me. That's, I knew he was going to say me. Now this is Nathan, and Nathan, tell us why you're getting baptized today.
I wanted to be baptized because I wanted to be Jesus' son, and because even though I know I'm already saved, I just want to follow what Jesus did before any of us lived.
Now Nathan's a blooming theologian. You may not know that. But this guy is studying his Bible. He's been in Awana for how long?
Like 2 years.
Okay. And tell me why you're, before she gets here, tell me why your mom's getting baptized today.
My mom wants to get baptized.
Well, didn't you tell her that she needed to get baptized?
No, she wasn't.
Oh, she wasn't. Oh, all right. Well, but didn't you go home and tell your mom she needed to start reading her Bible more?
Yes.
Tell me what you told your mom. I want to hear it.
I told my mom that I keep on praying for you to go to church because I want you to be saved with me so we can all live.
Wow.
So he's not only a little theologian, he's a little evangelist. So, and I'm worried another year or two he's going to be telling me how to do my job better. I know that's going to happen. So what I have is a little book on baptism, which you're welcome to have. And am I understanding that you read the whole thing? Or some of it?
I read some of it with my counselor in Awana. Her name is Miss Chris.
Okay.
She went over with it with me.
Krishna, stand up. I just want to say thank you for doing such a good job, because he actually went through a lot of the booklet, and we need 25 people leading Awanas, and you're just one of the people that have come in and made an impact, and I appreciate you. So, Nathan, are you ready to be baptized? Okay, have you accepted Jesus as your Lord and Savior?
Yes.
Okay. My pleasure to baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. So I didn't hold him down for 5 minutes like I said. So tell us why you're here today.
I'm here today because I feel like I have received
got you reading the Bible, if I remember, didn't he?
Yes.
Yeah. And so you guys started reading together. I think we had a night when I said, well, why don't you read John together?
Yes.
Okay. And so things have changed for you since then.
Yes.
In what way?
I'm a different me.
Yeah, she's a different? Yeah, you've told me that. A different me. And all of a sudden you're looking at life different?
Yes.
And you would say that you feel something inside has changed. Absolutely. It's hard to talk.
Yes. It's easier when it's just me and you.
just look at me then. And so why do you want to be baptized? Look at me.
I want to be baptized because I want to make want to accept Jesus as my Lord and my Savior.
Which you have, right? And you've had a history and through the Catholic Church of learning about Jesus, so it's not new to you. But Nathan kind of pushed you to think more seriously about it, didn't he?
Yes, he did.
And so what she's explained to me is that Okay, oh good, good. At a certain point when I put words in people's mouth, they want me to shut up.
So, Nathan was about second grade, and he came to me and he asked me, "Mom, why don't we ever go to church?" And I didn't have an answer for him. I said, "I don't know why we don't." And he said, "Well, there's this program at school. It's called the Good News Club, and they teach you about God. If you don't want to go to church, it's okay, but I want to learn more about God." And I said, "Okay." About a year went by after that. Every Wednesday, he would come home and have a new verse for me and tell me things and ask me, "Do you know why Jesus did this, or do you know?" And I honestly didn't have an answer for him. I would just listen to him. And then at the end of his Awana year, he came home with a bracelet and he said, "I want you to have this." And I said, "Okay." He said, "I made it for you. It's called a..." What was it called? It's basically a bracelet of what Jesus did, and he asked me, I want you to be closer to God. I want you to read the Bible with me." And so we started reading the Bible, and he then started coming to Awana and learning a lot in class. And then maybe a year after that, my friend Violet invited me to her church. And I started going every Sunday, and I knew that I was changing. It was a different me, and I started believing. I started really believing everything the Bible was teaching me, everything that, you know, the pastors would say would open up my eyes, and this is why now I'm here, because I want to accept Him as my Lord and my Savior.
So you accepted Jesus as your Lord and Savior. You have, haven't you? Yes. Then it's my privilege to baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Now, one of the reasons that I like them to get you talking, because you need to know that God's working and alive and well in people's lives, and I just like you to hear that. You got some Maria?
Buenas tardes a todos, Dios los bendiga. Estamos con la hermana María, que se va a utilizar el tomador de decisión de fe. Y quería preguntarle que si nos podía comentar algo de cómo llegó a los caminos del Señor.
Buenos días a todos, hermanos. Yo me acerqué y le voy a decir el motivo. ¿Quién me trajo aquí? Yo quiero agradecerle a esa persona. Ella se llama Vianel, que fue la que me invitó a esta iglesia. Y espero que un día venga ella aquí. Tengo fe que un día la voy a ver también aquí bautizando. Tengo la fe que la voy a ver. Y entonces yo tengo como 7-8 meses de estar viniendo a la iglesia, pero de aceptar a Dios como mi único salvador del mundo, tengo como 4 meses. Y la decisión mía de bautizarme, tal vez pueda ser que diga muy temprano, no sé, pero es por obediencia y porque el Señor ha hecho muchas cosas buenas. Él me ha bendecido mucho. Entonces, yo quiero agradecerle con bautizarlo porque estoy obedeciendo a Él. Estoy obedeciéndole a Él porque tengo que, mamá, Él dice que hay que bautizarse y yo quiero obedecerle a Él para seguir en sus caminos y que Él nunca me suelte de sus manos. Yo le he pedido al Señor que nunca me suelte de sus manos. Yo he creído en Jesucristo como el único salvador del mundo, que dio la vida de Él, dio su vida por mí. Y también quiero agradecerle al hermano Judy, que es el que me imparte que ha aprendido más de Dios, porque nos imparte unas clases especiales que nos gustaría que todo el mundo viniera a recibir viernes y martes, el miércoles de discipulación, y ahí es donde he aprendido más y estoy convencida que Dios es el que tiene aquí.
Bueno, tomando con ese paso de fe, lo vamos a bautizar en el nombre del Padre, del Hijo y del Espíritu Santo.
And she said, I don't have to talk, do I?
I want to get closer to God, and I know the meaning of baptism. Now I realize this is good to have baptism.
Have you accepted Jesus as your Lord and Savior?
Oh, yes.
That's okay. Then it's my privilege to baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. I'm just going to pray for them, okay? Oh, there's my guy. Heavenly Father, we give you thanks for this celebration of new life. We give you thanks that Jesus came into this world to die for our sins. We give you thanks, Heavenly Father, that the waters of baptism represent what He does in our life. It's cleansing us from our sins, not only now, but it cleanses us from sins whenever we do wrong and confess that we've done wrong, because you continue to clean us. And we give you thanks for the day when we'll receive our new bodies that will have no sin nature at all. We give you thanks for the promise of a new kingdom where there won't be evil, there won't be disasters, there'll be new life, and we'll then know fully what we only now know partially. Heavenly Father, give your Spirit in fullness to these four people that have been baptized. Give them wisdom to understand the Word of God and to understand the heart of Jesus, that they might live for Him everywhere they go. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.